Elliot.
7.
And do you know...
just a 7.
Yes, Elliot.
Aileron.
And...
Dariol.
Thank you. Popped up again.
Yes, the
Where would
pot.
We be without it? Richard.
down here.
Yes. Down here. And Susie.
Yes, Dariol. A few seconds there. Nothing more.
Thanks very much. So, 10 points in it, 69 days. 59, let's take a break and listen to Susie's wonderful origins of words. Susie.
Well, once again, the credit has to go to Stefan Horms and Silke Poost. I'm hoping I'm pronouncing those properly, but they are the creators of something I mentioned yesterday, the Atlas of True Names, which is this wonderful thing where you see the real meanings of the place names right around the world, places, mountains, rivers, etc. And unsurprisingly, countries and landscapes often derive their names from the characteristics of people who lived there. So Turkey translates as the land of the strong ones because they were known for their valour. Chicago translates as onion stink or onion stinkers. So they must have eaten a lot of onions, possibly garlic. But I'm going to talk about a place name which is closer to our hearts. And it all goes back to tattoos and the history of tattoos. The first proven tattoos in history were found on a mummy found in the Alps between Austria and Italy. Otzi the Iceman, he was known as. But in Europe, it became the early Britons, in fact, who made the art famous because when the Romans invaded in 55 BC, they found the native Britons to be completely covered in this wonderful body art. And Caesar wrote about them in his account of the Gallic Wars. He says, all the Britons dye themselves with woad, which is the dye obtained from a plant, a member of the cabbage family, which produces a blue colour and makes their appearance in battle more terrible. So they did that deliberately as a kind of battle costume, if you like. And they became known throughout Europe as the Pretani, which was the Celtic word meaning the painted or the tattooed ones. So we know that this tradition survived and in fact endured. Obviously it's endured to this day, but when the Normans arrived in 1066, they too discovered the British fondness for tattoos, and it became quite the fashion then. And this was one of the first practices, in fact, that the Normans adopted from the natives. All of which is bringing me to one particular name, which actually translates as the great land of the tattooed, and that is Great Britain.
That's not widely known, is it?
No, you have to go right back to ancient roots for that. So obviously we know it as Breton, which was the name that the Romans gave to, etc. But you don't normally go all the way back to know what that word actually means.
Well, it's rapidly living up to its name now. 69 to 59. Dinos, penultimate letters game. Off we go.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Dinos. G.
And a vowel.
I.
Consonant.
T.
Vowel.
E.
Consonant.